movies?
What? Sure, why not?
Nothing. Sure, you're left my own heart, that's all.
Quentin Tarantino.
When you came pulling in here, did you notice a sign on the front of my house that said Dead Nigger Storage?
Once the darling of the media set in the 90s, fated, considered one of the best directors in a new generation, one of the first breakout directors of the 90s, someone who has kept going strong right to this day, though a little more self-indulgent of late. Perhaps he's also considered a definitive example of a postmodernist filmmaker. Yet despite all of this, despite all the accolades heaped upon him, despite all the popularity of his previous work, now the media is turning on him. As Generation X gives way to the millennial generation, it seems that Quentin Tarantino has, within his own lifetime, abruptly and suddenly been found to be problematic.
Terry Sigouri, 6'6" of half-breed fury. But he's got a little problem. He has a hard time making friends.
You tell that bitch who sent you here how sorry I am I can no longer be her friend.
The Guardian has called for him to be cancelled, and it's far from the only one to raise a stink or to ask him awkward questions. Questions that he's dealt with rather adroitly. So what happened? Where did these accusations of misogyny, violence towards women, regressive attitudes, and so forth, where did these all spring from? They're not exactly new, but they just weren't taken particularly seriously in the past, so...
Well, I just reject your hypotheses.
Why now? Me too, notwithstanding. Not that he's been accused of anything like that. Is Quentin Tarantino a postmodernist? Like postmodernists, he rejects the artificial difference between high and low art that is a hallmark of postmodernist art, postmodernist filmmaking. If we consider him with a postmodernist lens, he explores media. Postmodernism is self-referential, it's about media, and he laces his films with references, in-jokes, nods, and so on that assume a certain degree of media literacy in his audience. Or at least the audience with that level of media literacy can get more out of his films. He deals in non-linear time, he cuts up his films, they interweave, there's suggestions of interlinks between them, and the timeline, and indeed the time setting of the films, is never really explicitly clear. And to a postmodernist, his mixing of different styles and tones, and that timeless sense of filmmaking, similar in its own way to what we see in Legion, that would make people believe he was a postmodernist filmmaker and has led to a great deal of postmodernist analysis of his movies. But is he a postmodernist?
I love that stuff, you know, the killing.
Modernism in cinema was made up of many different factors, but a few big ones are things that Tarantino is accused or rightly identified as being. He's an auteur. He likes to control everything. He has his own singular vision for his work, in a way not too dissimilar to Kubrick, who we can perhaps consider more of a modernist filmmaker, though nobody is entirely pure. Kubrick left questions. Kubrick was highly stylistic. But if we look at 2001, we can see a vision of the future, of progress, presented cleanly, realistically. Kubrick's work tends to be quite cool and cold, even when it is dealing with emotional subject matter. When we look at Tarantino, it's less clean, but he is an auteur. He likes control. If we look at, say, the sweeping vistas of The Hateful Eight, we can see Kubrick-like influences upon Tarantino, a more modernist style, whatever the other content of his movies. And Tarantino's movies, unlike postmodernist films, for the most part, do have definitive, if sullied, heroes. There is a sense of right and wrong. The revenge motif appears again and again and again throughout Tarantino's work, right from the very beginning. Reservoir Dogs was funded off the sale of the script for True Romance. And in True Romance, we see a hero who is fairly obviously something of a self-insert for Tarantino, and that's where I think we can start to see where the disconnect is, where the misidentification of what Tarantino is as a filmmaker takes place. You see, I don't think Tarantino is a postmodernist filmmaker. I think people have misdiagnosed and misunderstood everything that he does as being postmodernist. But how could they make that mistake? The chaotic style, the mishmash of styles, the rule of cool that he uses throughout his films harks back to guerrilla filmmaking, exploitation cinema, Chinese martial arts and action cinema.
Damn, look like my women is on time.
Babe, I could show warm you up.
No shit, baby.
I can dig it.
Where they used whatever they had, whenever they could, in order to add value, where they acted like magpies, throwing in elements of all kinds of different things. That, despite having a larger budget, is where Tarantino is coming from. He unironically loves martial arts films, comic books, science fiction, the exploitation cinema of the 60s and 70s, the martial arts cinema of Hong Kong, the action cinema of Hong Kong. This isn't layered with irony. He genuinely, forthrightly and honestly enjoys it, and we can see that through his self-insert character in True Romance. Clarence unironically loves kung fu films, unironically loves comics, old cinema, music that nobody his age would really have liked, style that nobody his age really would have liked. And when he's set up with a prostitute by his well-meaning boss, he actually falls in love with her. That is his call to adventure. And it is the values, the heroism that he has learned from the movies and the comic books, and the chance to live up to that standard, that carries him through. He is free and clear and honestly heroic. And there is nothing to be embarrassed about to him or for his love. In that, that's where he draws his power.
I'm not eating because I'm not hungry. I'm not sitting because I'm not saying I ain't looking at the movie because I already seen it 7 years ago. It's the Mac. Max, Julian, Carol Speed, and Richard Pryor. I ain't scared of you, I just don't like you. And that envelope right there had some payoff money. Alabama's moving on to some greener pastures. We're not negotiating, I don't like to barter. It's in that envelope right there for my peace of mind. My peace of mind is worth that much. Not one penny more.
See you. Hong Kong cinema is notable for its sudden and rapid tonal shifts, as is exploitation cinema, about blaxploitation. And so on. You can go from tragedy to comedy to horror in a heartbeat. And similarly, we find that Tarantino's work is very hard to categorize due to these same tonal shifts. One moment you're laughing, the next you're horrified, the next you're scared, the next you're disgusted. It doesn't pin itself down to any singular emotional motif all the way through. This isn't postmodernism. This is Tarantino throwing up onto the screen the things that he himself loves, the things that influence him, the things that he enjoys, and that's why it's there. not irony, not deconstruction, not any of the things that the postmodernists read into what he does, but just an honest, straightforward love. Tarantino embodies the values that many of these people profess, but they aren't what they say they are. Is his work misogynistic? Is he misogynistic? Or, if we look more broadly at his films, are the women just simply subjected to the same level of trauma in the narratives as the men are? The same levels of torture, the same levels of violence? Is he expecting things from his female stars the same way he would expect them from his male stars in terms of physicality or guerrilla filmmaking, jumping in and do the thing? Is he just having equal expectations, and it is the withdrawal of benevolent sexism that is taking place rather than the imposition of negative sexism? In the final analysis, it comes down to this. Tarantino is not one of them. They mistook him for one of theirs. He embodies the values that they claim to value, that they claim to embody, but which they don't. Tarantino unironically loves trash cinema, not pastiche, not even homage. He puts what he loves onto the screen. In the same way, in a lot of ways, to the way George Lucas did when he created Star Wars. And a bit like Lucas, he has become loose and flabby and self-indulgent, riding off his past successes more recently. That's his real sin, if he has one.
Like a lot of you, I hate a lot, you know? But I hate with style and creativity.